Hello friends, welcome to the CADCAM CAE lecture series. Today we are going to see one more program on cant cycle drilling, okay, manual part program for cant cycle drilling. Okay, as you can see over here, I have a plate with overall dimensions as 150 mm by 120 mm. Okay, so 150 mm by 120 mm. Okay, the plate is having six holes. Okay, the plate is having six holes and all six holes are through holes. Okay, so as you can see, the hole diameter is 15 millimeters and there are total six number of holes and all holes are through holes. Now I have mentioned over here the hole numbers I have given. So hole numbers are going to be depicting the tool path that the drilling tool is going to follow. The tool path means in what sequence it is going to complete the drilling operation. So as you can see, I have started from this hole, that is hole number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the drilling tool is going to travel from this direction up in this direction and again it is going to go back to the set point. So this is a set point which is at -40, -40, 20. Okay, so set point is well away from the workpiece. Okay, -40, -40, 20. So from here initially the tool will come to the location number one, hole location number one, okay, which is 30, 30. Okay, which is 30, 30, and from here onwards it is going to travel in the horizontal direction, move up into the vertical row, again travel back into the horizontal direction, and from hole number 6 it is going to go back to the set point. So that is what the tool path for the drilling operation. Okay, it doesn't actually matter saying tool path for drilling operation, but we must have a sequence because it is a pattern hole drilling, because the code will change if I change the sequence. Okay, if I change these numbers, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, if I keep, okay, it is going to change the code slightly. Okay, the motion statements, coordinate statements in the initial in the cant cycle program, okay, will be affected. So that is why we must ensure that what exactly is the path will be followed by the tool. Okay, and since it's a drilling tool, okay, it doesn't matter because it's not a path operation, it's a point to point operation, but still it will matter because it's a pattern hole drilling that we want to target. Okay, so as you can see, the program is written over here, okay, with the initial percent sign, okay, percent MPF followed by the program number. Okay, then I have some information regarding the program. So it is a drilling cutter diameter 15 mm HSS drill, okay, which I am calling it as tool number 01, so T01, and drilling cant cycle program. So it's a drilling cant cycle program. Okay, now I have first I will have all the cancellation codes just to make the system okay ready for the new fresh program. So it is a G00 is for the rapid mode, G49, G40, G80. So cancel tool length compensation, diameter compensation, and cancel any predefined cant cycle operation. Okay, so this is going to ensure that the program will start with a fresh setting, okay, on the machine. So machine control unit will reset all the previous settings if those settings are still active. So it is just a double check, okay, double check, not to fall in any predefined settings. Okay, so we are going to double check and make sure that we have the cancellation codes in the initial lines or initial block of the program. Then I define the G71, that is the metric programming. So my unit system is going to be MKS, and G90 is for the absolute positioning system. So I will be initially referring to the absolute positioning and the original coordinates of the points. Okay, then I move to the next point, that is N010, G00, X-40, Y-40, Z20. So I assign the home position, okay, of the tool, x minus 40, y minus 40, z 20. Okay, now in last lecture we had seen one method of writing the coordinates. Okay, this is another method of writing the coordinates. Okay, you can place dot. Okay, you can place dot after each coordinate that you enter. Okay, after each coordinate that you enter. So x minus 40 dot, y minus 40 dot, z 20 dot. Okay, so this is also one way of declaring the coordinates in the manual part program. Okay, once my tool once I reach the home position, okay, I can carry out the tool change and have the correct tool, okay, installed. Okay, so I carry out the tool change operation and change the tool to tool number T01, which is 15mm HSS drill. Okay, which is 15mm HSS drill. Okay, now in the next line, I define the first whole coordinate. So G00, x 30 dot, y 30 dot, z 10. So I bring my tool from set point to this exactly at the hole number 1 location, which is at 30, 30, and I have arranged the tool 10mm above the workpiece. Okay, 10mm above the workpiece. So the coordinates are 30 dot, x 30, y 30, z 10. Okay, then I will switch on the spindle. So spindle speed is going to be 1100 rpm. Okay, and the spindle will be switched on in clockwise direction. So then I move into the next line. Okay, I ensure that G43. Okay, I ensure that G43. So cutter length compensation in positive direction is switched on. Okay, remember we cancelled all the length compensations, diameter compensations, and cant cycles. Okay, now it is a time to give the compensations because we will be starting the drilling operation. Okay, we will be starting the drilling operation. So cutter length compensation in positive direction. Okay, I am going to switch it on. So G43 is a code for it. Okay, Z2 I am going to define as the initial level. Okay, Z2 I am going to define as the initial level. Okay, that initial level will be defined with the help of Z2 dot and H1. Okay, so H1 is a register. Okay, H is a register. So H and L, okay, these are the two special letters kept for the register memory on the machine control unit. Okay, that is going to handle the reference values. Okay, so whatever reference value we define after Z, okay, for drilling operation will be stored in this register H. Okay, H1. Okay, so Z2 dot H1 and M07. I'm going to switch on the flood type coolant. Okay, switch on the flood type coolant, and then I'm going to enter my cant cycle operation. So cant cycle, drilling cant cycle on the milling machine center. So on the next line, N030 G81 is for the cant cycle on. Okay, drilling cant cycle on milling center. G99 is for the return to initial level. Okay, return to initial level, which is already being defined on the previous block. Okay, which is already being defined on the previous block. So now machine control unit knows at what level it has to return. Okay, at what level it has to return. Then I will specify again the first coordinate, that is x30, y30, and then since the whole since the plate is of thickness 20, okay, and we have already set Z equal to 0 as the top plane of the this coordinate system. Okay, so I have to achieve a depth of minus 20 minimum. Okay, and since we are carrying out a drilling operation and drill bit has a tip point. Okay, drill bit has a tip point. Okay, so to ensure a finished drill. Okay, ensure a finished drilled or through hole. Okay, we are going to bring the tool slightly down, okay, below 20. So I have decided to bring it down to minus 23. Okay, so x30, y30, z minus 23. So this z minus 23 is a vertical downward movement of the tool. Okay, when the tool is rotating clockwise at 1100 rpm. Okay, and reference to, okay, R2 is going to ensure that the initial level 2 is achieved once the drilling is complete. Okay, and the drill will be carried out, the drilling operation will be carried out at a feed rate of 100 millimeters per minute. Okay, so the drill is going to go down till Z minus 23 at 100 millimeters per minute, and once this drilling is complete, okay, the tool will move up at a rapid rate. Okay, tool will move up at a rapid rate up to reference level or up to initial level Z equal to 2 mm. Okay, Z equal to 2 mm. Okay, once this is done, Okay, now what we are doing? Okay, instead of giving different coordinates, okay, instead of using the absolute positioning system, where we will have to define the coordinates of each whole location, okay, what we will be doing is we will be making use of the incremental positioning system. So what we are doing, okay, in the next block I am changing the mode into the incremental positioning, G91. And what G91 will ensure, the current position of the tool, which is at location number 1, okay, is an origin location. And if I have to specify the next location, then I have to specify with respect to this origin and not with respect to this origin, because what we normally assume is the bottom left corner of the workpiece is the origin, okay, and in absolute positioning system we assume this origin and dimension all the workpiece, all the points on the workpiece we take reference from this workpiece origin, okay. But when we are using the incremental positioning system, at that time we don't follow this workpiece origin, but instead we follow the origin where the tool is currently positioned, okay. So current position of the tool becomes the origin for the tool, okay, and accordingly we give the next location for tool. So if I have to specify the next location of tool, that is hole number 2, okay, what is changing? Only the x coordinate is changing, and that too it is changing by the amount 45. So if I specify x 45, the tool will readily move to this location, okay, in a horizontal direction it will move to this location. Its y will remain 0 according to the incremental positioning system, okay, incremental positioning system. So that's what I have given over here, G91 incremental positioning, and whatever is changing, only that I am specifying, that is x45. So it is location number 2 or drill hole number 2. Okay, what will happen as soon as the MCU gets, the machine control unit gets the coordinate, okay, as soon as it gets the coordinate, it is going to repeat Z-23 at feed 100 millimeters per minute, and it is going to return to reference level Z equal to 2 mm, okay, or initial level Z equal to 2 mm. So this will be a repeat motion carried out as soon as it reaches the this line, okay. So this will be carried out, okay. So we have drilled 2 holes so far. Okay, now I am already in incremental positioning. So now next I will only specify whatever the coordinate change is happening. So from hole number 2 to hole number 3, again I am moving in the x direction by distance 45. Now hole number 2 will become my origin, okay, and again I am moving in forward direction, so positive x 45. My y coordinate, as far as the incremental positioning system is concerned, is still 0. Okay, so that's what happens over here. Okay, when I give x 45, again the CAN cycle is active, so it will carry out Z-23 at feed rate 100 millimeters per minute, and it will bring the tool up to Z equal to 2 mm, that is initial level, okay, at the rapid rate. Then what happens? Okay, I have drilled 3 holes, okay, 1, 2, 3. Now this is my origin, okay, this is my origin. Now I have to move up, okay, now I have to move up. So I don't have to change x coordinate now, but I have to change y coordinate by distance 60, okay. So my next line is going to be y60, okay, my next line is going to be y60. The moment it sees that there is a coordinate change, same thing will be repeated, same motion will be repeated. So Z equal to minus 23 at feed rate 100 millimeters per minute, and then the tool will be returning to initial level, that is Z equal to 2 mm. Okay, then what happens is I have drilled hole number 4. Now this is my origin. Okay, now I have to move to the left side by distance x equal to minus 45. Okay, by distance x equal to minus 45. So that's what I have written, x minus 45. Okay, so that is my drill hole number 5. As soon as MCU gets the coordinate change, that is x minus 45, it is going to repeat the motion, that is Z minus 23 at feed rate 100 millimeters per minute. And it is going to return the tool to initial level, that is Z equal to 2 mm. Okay, and then I have reached hole number 5. I have drilled the hole number 5 and reached to the initial level. Okay, now this is my origin. Okay, I will again give x minus 45. So that's what I have given here, x minus 45. So that is my drill hole number 6. Okay, as soon as it gets the coordinate change, it is going to repeat the motion, that is z minus 23 at feed rate 100 millimeters per minute, and then it is going to bring back the tool to initial level of z equal to 2 mm. So in this way we have completed all the six holes. Okay, all the six holes. Okay, we didn't have to do much because since we have used the incremental positioning system, our work of specifying the coordinate was very easy. Okay, our work of specifying coordinates was very easy. We only had to specify the coordinate which is changing. Now, if I am moving horizontally, my y coordinate is not changing, so I will not have to specify it. Okay, when I am moving vertically, my x coordinate is not changing, so I don't have to specify it. So when I am working with incremental system, incremental positioning system, okay, my work is fairly easy as far as how I am going to specify the coordinates. So you don't have to calculate coordinates. Even if it's a complex kind of a pattern, circular pattern, still the incremental positioning works like wonders, okay, and it saves a lot of time of calculating the each and every coordinate, okay, according to the global coordinate system or Cartesian coordinate system or absolute positioning system. Okay, so once we complete the drill hole number 6 and reach to its initial level z equal to 2, okay, then what we do, we cancel the cant cycle. Okay, so G80 is for the cancelling the cant cycle, G98 is for the returning to reference level. Now what was the reference level? Reference level is here, that is z equal to 10, okay, which we set, which was the reference level before the initial level. Okay, before the initial level, so initial level was set up as z equal to 2. Before that, the tool was at z equal to 10. Okay, z equal to 10. So G98 will ensure that Z10 is achieved. Okay, Z10 is achieved. Once the tool goes back to z equal to 10, we are going to switch off the spindle and we are going to switch off the coolant supply. So M05, M09. So cancel cant cycle, return to reference level. Spindle is off, coolant is off. Okay, spindle is off, coolant is off. Okay, then we will change to rapid mode. Okay, we will change the positioning system to absolute again. Okay, and we'll take the tool back to the set point. Okay, we'll take tool back to the set point. If we are not changing G90 over here and writing X minus 40, Y minus 40, Z20, then what will happen? Okay, from here, that is its current location is this. Okay, the tool will come down to minus 40 in X. Okay, minus 40 in X, so it will come somewhere here, minus 40 in Y. Okay, so the tool will not reach the actual home position or set point of the workpiece, but it will end somewhere here. Okay, so that is why it is very important once you start the G91, okay, which is also a modal command, okay, you have to change the mode to some other command, that is G90. Okay, now G91 is an incremental positioning. Okay, unless and until you change it back to G90, which is absolute positioning, the machine control unit will remain in G91 mode, that is incremental mode. So that is very important. After writing G00, I have changed the positioning system to absolute positioning and then I am specifying the coordinates. So once I have changed back to absolute positioning, now X minus 40, Y minus 40, Z20 means this set point according to the this reference coordinate, okay, for the absolute positioning, and then I am going to end the program. Okay, I am going to end the program. So this was a very short description program just to showcase how the cant cycle can be made to work with the help of incremental positioning system and how it simplifies the programmer's job. Okay, how it simplifies the programmer's job. So I hope you have understood this. Okay, I hope you have understood this. Okay, we just had 6 holes. Okay, but if there are, let's say, 20 holes, okay, in this way, and I have, say, plate dimension instead of 150 along X, if I have, let's say, 500 along X, okay, and I continue along the length to drill, let's say, 15 holes, okay, in this way, okay, then also the program is gonna be remaining in a similar way. Every time we will be changing the X coordinate by 45. Okay, every time we'll be changing X coordinate by 45. Okay, having more holes, okay, doesn't really affect the programmer's job. Okay, so programmer's job with incremental positioning system is very easy. He just have to give the next coordinate, keeping the current position of the tool as the origin. So that saves lot of calculation part. Okay, that saves lot of calculation part. Okay, but it still increases, let's say, number of lines. Okay, it still increases number of lines. So there are other ways to work with the manual part program and try to reduce the number of lines when we are working with the pattern hole drilling. Okay, when we are working with the pattern hole drilling. So in the next lecture, we will see few loops. Okay, loop programming. Okay, which are going to reduce the number of lines and ensure that the repetitiveness is only declared. Okay, number of times we want to execute it. Okay, so that is possible with the loop program. So in the coming next lecture, we will have a look at the loop programming for the GNM codes, and that is for manual part programming. So I hope you have understood this CAN cycle drilling with the help of incremental positioning system. Okay, to carry out drilling which is being required to follow certain pattern holes. Okay, patterns. So I hope you have understood, and see you next time with more such interesting content on computer aided manufacturing. Okay, thank you very much.